Hi. I'm learning more and more about how to make videos, and I don't want to make them too long, so I'm going to make little wee ones and learn how to edit. And that's kind of like erasing it, so that you can take out some parts and make it shorter. And so I made a video about some little creatures that I found when I was, I found some mushrooms and I was doing experiments. And so I brought them home and I put them on a piece of paper. I took the stem off and then put the top of the mushroom on a piece of paper. And it makes something called spore prints, and they're different colors. And I'm trying to learn. There's all different kinds. And I never eat the mushrooms I find or experiment with because I don't know enough information. Some people are very smart and they know the ones that we can buy in the stores and which ones are healthy and which ones are not healthy. But I don't know that, so I never eat the ones I find. But maybe when I get smarter, because sometimes people can learn a lot, know all the names of all, just like dinosaurs. You might know all the names of dinosaurs. Some people know all the names of all the mushrooms, or birds, or whatever. I'm noticing so many birds by my house. I'm finding this one with red, like a red crayon. On his head. And I thought, we don't even have birds around here with red on their head, but we do. I didn't know that, but we do. It's called a house finch. It sounds like such a common thing, but I just didn't maybe pay attention before. Anyway, so I paid attention to these mushrooms, and when I lifted, I put a cover over it so air wouldn't disturb the spore print, because spores are these tiny dust things underneath the mushrooms that drop down, and that's how they have babies. And then those spores make new mushrooms, and they're different colors. And so that's how one way you can know. And I lifted it up to see the spore print, but inside were creatures, so many creatures. They were decomposers. That's what I'm going to call them, because people call these little creatures all different things. I did find. I was looking them up to learn more, and I found something called a fungus worm, I think, which slightly better. It's the M word. I just can't say it. But anyway, they are very interesting. I did not know all the stuff. They used to use these same creatures, not maybe exactly the same, not the ones that I found in the mushroom, but they used to use them when you had a bad owie and it wouldn't get healthy and it had all this yucky, gross stuff all around it. They used to put these creatures there and the creatures took away all the sick part and just left the healthy part on your skin. Who knew? And also, I learned they leave behind a little trail of good medicine. That doctors can use. They make some sort of, they leave behind good medicine. So sometimes people look at things like this and they go, oh, that's disgusting. Actually, Joe said that. Lots of people say that. Most people say that probably. Oh, that's disgusting. We don't want to see that. No. Like that. But actually, these creatures, and also just like my, I'm going to add to this a little tiny clip, hopefully, of my worms in my worm bin. They're downstairs. I was checking on them yesterday, giving them some new food, but there's so many. I could just lift up their little home and show you. But anyway, where was I going with this? Oh, so I just wanted to tell you about this, the little video that I have for you of this. I'm just learning how to do things. I'm learning how to make things go faster and slower. I'm learning how to make things go to music, add some music to it. Anyway. I miss you all a whole bunch. I think about you guys every day, yet it's getting weird. I'm getting used to not going to school, and it's starting to feel like a memory instead of something that's part of my world. It's not, it does, I mean, it isn't part of my world now, and it isn't part of your world. You have a different world, though. You have the world. Well, I see. I look on the internet, and I see some nice stuff kids are doing. I like it when the parents share that, and it does kind of make me feel like I'm a little bit still in that world. But I do miss you all, even the people that I don't see things on the internet. I still think of you, and I miss you, and I think of really dumb jokes that only you guys would like, and really interesting things, or like, you know, sometimes I get bored and I start taking stuff apart, and like other grown-ups would just go, what'd you take that apart for? And I have to put it all together. But you guys, I mean, that's one reason I like being with you guys so much, because I could go, wow, look at this thing I took apart, and you'd all be going, oh, wow, look at that, let me try. You know, so I miss kind of sharing that stuff with you too. Anyway, but take things apart at your house. Maybe you talk to your parents about it, but if you're curious, I just hope you're curious. Please stay curious. And just get yourself a little screwdriver and a little wrench. I mean, there's things to undo. Or maybe, I mean, you have parents home. Maybe they, well, they're probably busy. But, I mean, there's wrenches and bolts and nuts and screws and wing nuts. And even if you can't take something apart, you could put something together. I don't know. I'm just rambling. I hope you're all well. And I think I'll make one more little bit just like this and stick it at the end and say, okay, that was it. Or maybe I'll even do that now, because now I learned how to cut the video and then move it to, okay, so this is the part where I'm going to cut. I'll make a hand motion so I can see it on my video thing. Okay, I'll go like this. Oh, no, wait, don't they go like this? Oh, I think they go like this in the real movies. They go, well, they have like a chalkboard with this little top thing, and they go like that. I don't know what that, it's kind of like if this was the little chalkboard, and then there's this little stick, and they go like this, cut. All right, this is a mushroom. There's a couple of them hiding. And over here, I'll try not to go too quick. That one, and that one's old, and it's all curling up. And there's some more. Look here. So this is what I had. And then I put it on a piece of paper and I found all those creatures. All right, let's see how this goes. See all of them? Hi. I better set it down so I don't get everybody car sick. And they came from this. Well, that wasn't too brilliant. And if I pick it up and turn it over, I think if that's even possible, because it's really falling apart. You can see. I don't know what you can see. Let me see. There you go. They're hiding. They were all hanging out. The ones on the paper aren't going to be able to hide. There. But they are shy. Look, they're trying to get away. They're probably going to be all over my house. I won't show Joe this. Wow, look at them. They all have an idea of which way to go. Isn't that interesting? Head for the hills, guys. Obviously, this is the hill. Wow. I can imagine, like, horse racing music. Like, I didn't clean the rest of my house. I just cleared a small area on the table. But if they really travel, I'm going to have to reveal that the table's full. Let them go. This way, guys. Come on. Don't be afraid. It's just a piece of paper. It's not very high. Where are they heading to? Ooh, one's already on, because I already did this the other day. And one, look. Come here, fella. Because I'm learning about mushrooms, but what I'm learning is they have people inside, or not people, but, you know, creatures. Oh, that one's hiding. I see it now. It's hiding under this. Is that true? Yeah, look. So he's like, maybe they're, I don't know. I don't know anything about them, if they have a long life or a short life. I'm guessing short. And what was that? Oh, that's an ant. And they just had sort of a, oh, now look, he's having some sort of fit. Oh, dear. Oh, he's stuck with a hair. Do you see that little hair thing he's got? Is he eating it? I don't know. I don't know. I don't know if it's, now what's he going to do? He's found these dried ones. I don't know. Where did the others get off to? I think you may have, like, something stuck on you. Oh, here's a friend. Is that a hair? Or what? I can't even tell where you guys are. Hi, where are you going? I'm going this way. You have to jump over that big hair. Where are you going? Oh, you're going out of focus. Oh, and fast, right? What are you aiming for, the edge of the world, dude? I'll show you what happens. See this edge? We're gonna watch. It's like Mutual of Omaha, Wild America. If you were a child, you would go, ooh, wee, a slide, until you get to the steep part. I don't know what your relationship with gravity is. Oh, here's the part. You guys, before we call it a day. Yeah. Okay, fellas. Hi, I'm at my worm bin. I'm gonna quickly eat this banana. I probably should have planned this out better because there's quite a bit left. The top of the worm bin is covered with shredded paper. Like when, you know, you can put that paper into, some people might have a shredder at their house, they put the paper in, it goes and it comes out all little pieces. Okay, here's the last bite. The point is, they love this. Here we go. This is my worm bin, and on the top is the shredded paper. And there's the banana peel from the banana I just ate. And this is a piece of an eggshell, let's see. And there's an apple core right there. Probably shouldn't be touching this with my hands. Let me get, here, I got a thing. And I'm gonna try and zoom in and show you the creatures, let's see. They're really shy. Well, there are, well, that's another topic. Let's see. So, and I probably should cut that up, but I'm not going to. I'm just going to bury it. Let's see what we can find. If we can find some creatures in here. Okay. There we go. And the real thing is, these are decomposers, so these will change everything into dirt, really good dirt, that people have to buy a lot, pay a lot of money for at the dirt at the store, because they have special dirt made by worms. They run away from light and stuff as soon as I, that's why I keep them covered. I put the food in, so that's all, and then put more of this junk on top. I'll bury that banana peel a little better. And then they'll eat it. And I don't know. I mean, I should check back and see how long does it take for it to turn into dirt. I don't know. Never really timed it. Probably could use a little more of the stuff on top. So, hold on. All right, so let's see. pretty good. And then I cover it. And now there's other layers that I don't put food on, and it's just their world. Let me back up. See all these different worlds? I used to play a game called Torin's Passage, which you can still buy, but it's really old and clunky. And it had different worlds. It's an okay for kids game. I used to love that. Anyway, so it's like different worm worlds. The bottom one is just liquid, and then at the very bottom, there's a bucket, and that's worm juice, and that's the liquid that comes through the worms, I guess you could say. And that's really good for your garden too. All right, that's this. Okay, that was the video about the little decomposers that live in the mushroom and make good things for the earth. And also the video of the other decomposers, my redworms that live in my worm bin that eat my banana peels and eggshells and apple peel and stuff like that. But anyway, I miss you all, and I'll make another one now that I'm getting smarter and smarter. And these hopefully will be shorter and shorter. All right. All right. Bye-bye. I love you. Bye.